Welcome to Saturday or Sunday worship with us at Emmanuel Online Worship again. I know we're all disappointed that we can't gather together during this time, but we're doing our best to bring church home to you. And so we hope that you will find what we've prepared meaningful to you in these difficult days. We're at the fourth Sunday in Lent, and the theme today is going to be, what do you see? That's in the gospel lesson today. So, you know, what do you see? What do you see going on in the world today? And how do we see God at work in our lives, even now at this tough time? One person emailed what I thought was a great idea just today, and that is that we take selfies of each other worshiping at home around the TV or around the computer or however you're doing it. If you're comfortable doing that and would be willing to let us share those pictures, that would be great. So if you would send us a selfie of you worshiping at home, we could then use that in some of our upcoming worship services. And get it to us however you can, through email, you can post it on Facebook, we'll find it there if you do it that way. But I think that would be a great idea to try to, again, show each other that we're still worshiping together and still connecting with Christ in the middle of this crisis. So God's blessings to you, and I hope you enjoy the worship. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Most merciful God, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for you, and for his sake, God forgives you all your sins. To those who believe in Jesus Christ, he gives the power to become the children of God and bestows on them the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh,
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
By your gracious life and death for us, bring light into the darkness of our hearts and anoint us with your Spirit. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Gospel according to St. John, the 9th chapter. As he passed by, he saw a man blind from birth, and his disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus answered, it was not that this man sinned or his parents, but that the works of God might be displayed in him. We must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. Night is coming when no one can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. Having said these things, he spit on the ground and made mud with the saliva. Then he anointed the man's eyes with the mud and said to him, "Go wash in the pool of Siloam," which means sent. So he went and washed and came back seeing. They brought to the Pharisees the man who had formerly been blind. Now it was a Sabbath day when Jesus made the mud and opened his eyes. So the Pharisees again asked him how he had received his sight, and he said to them, "He put mud on my eyes, and I washed, and I see." Some of the Pharisees said, "This man is not from God, for he does not keep the Sabbath." But others said, "How can a man who is a sinner do such signs?" And there was a division among them. So they said again to the blind man, "What do you say about him, since he has opened your eyes?" He said, "He is a prophet." They answered him, "You were born in utter sin, and would you teach us?" And they cast him out. Jesus heard that they had cast him out, and having found him, said, "Do you believe in the Son of Man?" He answered, "And who is he, sir, that I may believe in him?" Jesus said to him, "You have seen him, and it is he who is speaking to you." He said, "Lord, I believe," and he worshiped him. Jesus said, "For judgment I came into this world, that those who do not see may see, and those who see may become blind." The Gospel of the Lord. Grace, mercy, and peace to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. In our Lenten sermon series today, we were going to be focusing on the forgiveness of sins in the Lord's Supper. But since the Lord's Supper is on hold for a while here, and we're not able to gather together, I'm shifting the focus today to a key issue that's addressed by today's gospel lesson. And it's directly relevant to what we are all experiencing with COVID-19. It's about, what do you see? This gospel reading is about how we see things. And I'm not talking about the science of eyesight, iris, cornea, pupil, rods and cones, optic nerve, and all of that. Jesus wasn't really talking about that kind of eyesight, even though he did miraculously restore the eyesight of that man born blind. The key to getting today's gospel reading comes from the very end, when Jesus says, "For judgment I came into the world, that those who do not see may see, and those who see may become blind." He's not talking about physical eyesight there. He's talking about how you see the world, how we look at other people, how we see our life experiences and circumstances, and how we see God in the midst of all of it. While this reading is from the lectionary, and the lectionary was set up many years ago by people who had never even heard of COVID-19, what a perfectly appropriate reading for these times, these circumstances. What do you see? That's the question. We've seen statistics that paint a bleak picture: a spreading virus, death tolls increasing, still lots of uncertainty and fear. We've seen a robust economy wrenched into a morass of uncertainty and dysfunction. We've seen the worst of people in this, people having fights outside of stores because they didn't get enough toilet paper. We've seen politicians and others turning what should be a time of unity as we all fight a common enemy into yet another opportunity for petty political maneuvering. We've seen snarky comments toward those who have faced difficult decisions recently. As Jesus says it, those who think they see have become blind. What do you see? Here's what I see. Doctors, nurses, other medical professionals putting themselves in harm's way for the sake of others, putting others' needs ahead of their own. Here's what I see. Churches adjusting to having the center of our lifeblood ripped away from us, weekly worship gathering, and then gathering in creative ways online. I have to tell you that our entire church and school staff have been a joy to work with this past week. We are all in uncharted territory, doing things in ways that few of us have experience with or were even prepared for. And yet, I'm so proud to work with our faithful and dedicated staff here at Emmanuel, and proud of them for stepping up. I'm so proud that our staff is taking on new challenges with servant hearts. Here's what I see. Our school teachers and teachers throughout the community stepping up and working extra hard to provide online learning for during this time while school is closed. Here's what I see. Our food pantry ministry made an adjustment, a big one, to stay open by switching to handing out food from our portico share door so that the clients can simply drive up and we can place a bag of groceries in their car. And I have to tell you that during the week, on Tuesday, the first day we were doing that, our phone rang a lot in the morning from people wondering if we were going to be even having the food pantry open anymore. And they were so thankful and so overjoyed that the food pantry was going to remain open. Here's what I see. We here at church keep getting emails from people offering to help in one way or another. And we're putting together a list of those who have offered help, and as needs arise, we're going to be contacting people. So I would encourage you, if you're moved to help in some way, please email our administrative assistant, Angela, at churchoffice@emmanuelvalpo.org. Here's what I see. We were able to provide a Wednesday evening worship experience online this past week on pretty short notice. Musicians, singers eagerly offered to help, and most important of all, Kristen, our communications director, recorded and compiled and edited all of this video. And you know, while it's easy for those of us who sit at home to watch a video like that, it takes so much time and expertise and work to put that together. So I see Kristen going above and beyond in this difficult time with a servant heart. Here's what I see. We had planned throughout Lent Wednesday evenings to have people give personal testimonials about their experience of prayer. And we decided early this week that we wanted to include those by recording them and including them as part of the video. So two of our staff people, Matthew Rasmussen and Chris Prala, went over to Ruth Eskelson's house to record her statement. And after they were done recording, Matthew was kind of admiring Ruth's piano, and Ruth said, "Oh yeah, the piano's over 100 years old." And she said, "Would you like to play it?" And Matthew said, "Well, Ruth, what's your favorite hymn?" And Ruth said, "On my heart, imprint your image." Chris and Matthew were kind of stunned when she said that, because that was one of the hymns we had just recorded because we were going to use it the night that she was giving her testimonial this past Wednesday. And I suppose some people might see that as a coincidence. I see God at work in amazing ways during a difficult time. I see a story that I heard from a friend. It happened right here in Valparaiso. An elderly couple was sitting in their car in the grocery store parking lot. They were afraid to go in. They got my friend's attention, and so she went over to their car window, they rolled it down, and they handed a $100 bill to her in their grocery list, and they said, "We're afraid to go into the store. Would you please shop for us and get our groceries for us?" And my friend, of course, did. So I see the goodness and mercy of God, the love of Jesus at work in the midst of all of this. You know, when Jesus' disciples saw that man born blind, their first question was, "Who sinned, this man or his parents?" All they saw was a blind guy, just a sinner, just someone who was somehow to blame for his predicament. They thought they saw, yet they were blind. And Jesus straightened them out. Don't blame his parents. Rather, see him as an opportunity to give thanks and praise to God and to call you forth to serve. When the Pharisees heard that the man had been healed, what they saw was a threat. It wasn't done on the right day. It wasn't done in the right way, the way they would have approved. And because of the way that they saw things, they kicked the guy out of church for getting healed by Jesus. They thought they saw, yet they were blind. Jesus healed the man born blind, setting him on a path of increasing sight. Even though his physical eyesight was restored immediately, it took him a while to really see what Jesus wanted him to see. He didn't want the guy, that is Jesus, didn't really just want the guy to see his parents and animals, trees and sunsets. He didn't want the guy to just see the disdain of his own disciples or the scorn of the Pharisees. He wanted that man to see the forgiveness, the mercy, the goodness, the love, the life of God by seeing Jesus for who he truly was. Here's how the guy's sight increased. The very first time he talked to the Pharisees, the first thing the healed man said of Jesus was just the plain old physical facts. "Well, he put mud on my eyes and I washed and I see." Okay, that's fine. But as time went on, he began to see more. The next time he talked about Jesus, when the Pharisees asked him again, he said, "You know, I think that guy is a prophet." A little better. Finally, when Jesus found him and spoke with him personally, the healed guy cried out, "Lord, I believe." And he worshiped him. He saw. He finally saw what Jesus meant him to see all along, the grace and goodness, the mercy and love of God revealed in Jesus. And that's what Jesus wants us to see today, right in the middle of COVID-19. Those who claim to really see are often blind to what God is up to in the world. Jesus wants us to see with his eyes, to see hope in the midst of terrible circumstances, to see our neighbor not as a threat, but as someone loved by God, to see the love of God revealed through medical care, online education, online church, drive-up food pantry, neighbors helping neighbors. He wants us to see him as Lord and to join that man born blind who had been healed in worshiping him. In Jesus' name, amen. This is the point in worship where we would normally take the offering, but obviously we can't do that. So we're encouraging everyone to either mail in your offering or sign up for online giving. There should be a little note at the bottom of the screen here showing you where to go for that. You can also easily find it on our website. Again, just a reminder that our staff is working hard through these difficult times, and we've made a commitment to continue to pay our hourly workers as long as we can. And you are an important part of that by keeping giving as God has blessed you so that you may bless others. Thank you.
I have a couple of announcements before we turn our attention to prayer. First, encouraging you to sign up for emails. You can go to our website, emmanuelvalpo.org, and sign up to get email updates from our church. Also there at the website, you'll find updates from Emmanuel about the response to COVID-19. So I encourage you to visit the website regularly. Also, if you become aware of people who have needs of various kind, food delivery, for example, parents who may need help with childcare, encouraging you to help however you can, and also to call the church office as we work to coordinate a response to people in need. In our prayers today, we remember those known to us who have needs of various kinds. We continue to pray for those receiving hospice care, including Carolyn Garden, Sylvia Berg, and Kent Wartick. We mourn the death of Dee Edgecombe. Her funeral was Saturday, March 21st at Emmanuel. We continue to pray for all those who are affected by the pandemic. And we celebrate, even in the midst of the pandemic, we celebrate a birthday, that of Don Findling, who is 95 years old today. We kneel for prayer. As we journey toward the renewing waters of Easter, let us pray for the world, the church, and all who seek new life in Christ. For the church, that we see clearly the love of God for us in Christ Jesus. For Pastor Angone and outreach to Spanish-speaking people in our community, and for all ministers of the Word, that in these troubling and uncertain times of pandemic, the message of hope in Christ prevail over the messages of fear and despair. For all catechumens, that drawn to the font of rebirth, they may see in Jesus life and death, the embodiment of God's love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all leaders during this time of international pandemic, that they may be filled with wisdom, clarity, and compassion as they plan and communicate to their people. For public health officials, researchers, doctors, nurses, and all who are fighting the disease and caring for the infected. For those filled with fear, those whose lives are in turmoil because of cancellations, and for those whose income and livelihood are threatened by the coronavirus pandemic, that they experience also hope, peace, and provision in Christ. Let the church be a beacon of light in this dark time, looking not only to our own needs, but also to the needs of theirs. For those in the armed forces, for refugees fleeing from war, for innocent civilians in harm's way, for our enemies, and for soldiers struggling to adjust to life after deployment, that God's love for us in Christ lead us all toward lasting peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the sick, for those who are dying and their caregivers, for those who mourn, those we have named before you, and those we name in our hearts or aloud, that they may know God's help and compassion. For our food pantry, that the hurting and needy in our community find care and a sense of dignity through this ministry, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the families of Emmanuel, Roderick and Debbie Moore, Sharon and Barry Morris, Emily and Ted, Alan and Carrie Morrison, Helga Morton, Mark and Kathy Mozak, and Seth and Karen Mosley. Let the Spirit of Jesus work powerfully among them to create households of peace and patience, generosity and self-control. For Don Findling and his family, as they celebrate his 95th birthday, that their hearts be filled with thankfulness to God and love for one another. For this holy assembly, that seeing God's love for us in Jesus, we may see the world around us anew as an opportunity to demonstrate Jesus' servant love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Dee and all those who have gone before us in the faith and are at rest, we give thanks. Gather us together on that day when Christ comes again in glory and gives us life in the world to come. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Hear our prayers, Lord God, and look mercifully upon our repentance. Grant that this season of Lent prepare us well to approach Easter with joy. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen. Amen.
marked with the cross of Christ, go forth to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.